Hi everybody, this is John Andrews, Social and Digital Media Manager for Redport Information Assurance. Today's topic, still focusing on information security, brings forth something that I find very useful in everyday computer usage, really. Now, I know a lot of people, including students, family members, and businessmen who like to work on the go very often. There are times, though, where they can or they simply won't bring their computers with them wherever they go. So this brings the question, where do they keep all their work? Yes, there's the use of cloud storage, such as iCloud for Apple, SkyDrive through MSN, the drive through Google, Dropbox that helps store all of the documents and media that you want to access through another computer. But I know a lot of people who still use flash drives as well as external hard drives. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but I've probably gone through about 10 flash drives, not because I run out of room on each one, but simply because I misplace them somewhere. External hard drives, on the other hand, are a little different. You know, at about $100 a pop, it's a little hard to try and not lose them because of value. But say you do lose one of these valuable products that have tons and tons of information on them, especially information regarding something that has to do with your job or papers you've written or documents that have confidential information on them that other people shouldn't really know about. Well, if you lose one of these in the first place, you've lost it all unless you have a backup of it somewhere else. But now you have somebody who has all of your information where they could simply just plug it into their own laptop or computer and see everything you have, unless you put passwords on them or encrypt your disk. I'm going to show you real quick through a Mac how you can encrypt or put passwords on your flash drives or external hard drives, so that way there anybody who plugs these in will need a password in order to see all of the information you have on it. Not just that, but if someone had intentions on keeping it, maybe they'd realize, hey, there's nothing I can really do with this now since I need a password, and they might just generously return it back to you or the owner. So let's get started. First, plug in whatever you have, flash drive or external, in your USB or FireWire port, whichever one you prefer and use. Here I have my flash drive labeled JP Andrews, which is my name, and my external hard drive, which is a Lacey. What I did previously, I had information on my flash drive, but what you are going to want to do is delete everything off of your flash drive before you encrypt it, because what you're actually going to do is you're going to reformat the disk. So that way there it erases everything before you put a password on it. So what I did is I just took all the contents that were inside of my flash drive and put them all into my hard drive. Now, before you start, make sure you select the right disk that you're going to partition or encrypt. And what you're going to want to do is you can either go to Applications, and then scroll down to your Utilities folder where you're going to find Disk Utility. And Disk Utility is right there, right here. You're going to click on this, and when this window comes up right here, you're going to select the disk that you want to partition or put an encryption password on. In this case, it's going to be my flash drive, the 8 gig. Now, once you go here, you're going to click on the Erase tab. And when the format option comes up here, you're going to click on this drop-down menu and you're going to select Mac OS Extended, Journaled Encrypted. And what that does is it basically, like I said, repartitions the whole drive, erases all of the content, and adds an encryption onto the disk. After you have this selected, you can name it whatever you want. I'm just going to put here password protected, so that way there whenever it gets plugged in, people will see and know that it's password protected before they even decide to even click on it. So once you name that, you can just push the erase button and you're gonna put in whatever password you'd like. Basically, the stronger it is, or the more symbols, uppercase letters, lowercase letters, spaces, the number of words will make the password stronger. And in this case, mine is good, just to make sure I have it. Yep. And then you're going to verify it. You can add a hint if you want to, but I prefer that you don't, because not only does this give someone an advantage to guessing your password, but it could, however, put you at risk with other accounts you may have. So after you have done this, all you want to do is click on erase, And down here, it's going to go through the encryption process. Once this is done, I will resume the video and I will let you know how it looks whenever you put back in the flash drive and then how you enter in a password to enable all of your contents. All right, hi guys. This is John Andrews back with the continued video of part one. What has happened here is that through the disk utility window, you now see that Lacey, my hard drive, external hard drive, is the only other hard drive other than my, you know, built-in hard drive through the computer that is mounted. The password protected disk that I just encrypted is now gone. What I did is that once it got done reformatting and repartitioning, I just ejected the disk and wanted to show you what it looks like now whenever you plug it in. Here I'm just going to exit out of the disk utility and I'm going to now plug in my flash drive. And what is going to happen, and you will see, is that it'll prompt you asking for your password. Enter a password to unlock the disk, password protected. And this is where I will enter in the password that I set up for the disk itself. All you gotta do, push unlock, and it'll now mount onto your desktop for you, or through your my computer, or actually this is just for a Mac, so you can't do this for a PC. Now you can open it up and you can access anything that's inside. Now you can take whatever contents that you backed up and now transfer them back into your now empty flash drive. Now you can do this with an external hard drive. I recommend though that you do it as soon as you buy or purchase an external hard drive. I wouldn't have 500 gigs of data on a hard drive and then back it up somewhere else and then repartition the hard drive just to have it encrypted. Yes, you can do it that way, but it'll take you a while to have all the files transfer and then going through the encryption process. If you have time, yes, you can do that, but I would recommend you do it as soon as you get the hard drive. But now, if you're not comfortable with setting a password on your things, let's say that you would have a hard time remembering it, or it would just be too much of a hassle to put a password in if you're really careful with your things and don't need a password, then all you could really do is do this as an alternative. You would open up a Word file, or in my case Pages, I use Pages as my Word document resource, and what you want to do is type something up with your information regarding contact information. Your name, I would put either your phone number or email. I wouldn't put your address where you live because that would just set up any type of security information flaw again. And you could save that file straight to your external hard drive without a password. And when you save it, I would save the document as open this if found. And this is just a quick example. I'm just going to put my name. And then let's just say this is my phone number. Please call if found. And what you can do is just go straight to file and then here to save as. If it'll save. Oh, I guess not. Well, I think it's just because of the screencast company I'm using that's not allowing me to do this, but you can do this on your own time away from the video. But if you have any questions, just feel free to drop a comment down in the comment box below. I'll be glad to answer any questions. You can either send me a direct message, but you know, be sure to subscribe to our videos and don't forget to check out our website at www.redport-ia.com, where we offer quality information assurance and computer security. I'll be sure to put all these websites and links down in the description bar for you to see and click on. Our Facebook page at www.facebook.com/redport, and also follow us on Twitter at @redport_IA. Remember that if your security is falling short, call Redport. All right, thanks. Bye.